Everyone, in this video lecture of Communication Engineering, I am going to discuss the second part of Unit 1 in which we discuss amplitude modulations MCQs. First question is the ability of the receiver to select the wanted signal among the various incoming signal is termed as sensitivity, selectivity, stability and none of the above. Hame kya karna hai? सिग्नल को सेलेक्ट करना है विच इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अस. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा, दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज कॉल्ड सेलेक्टिविटी. ठीक है, तो दिस इज द राइट आंसर. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सुपर हेट्रोडाइन रिसीवर्स हैव बेटर सेंसिटिविटी, हैव हाई सेलेक्टिविटी, नीड एक्स्ट्रा सर्किटरी फॉर फ्रीक्वेंसी कन्वर्जन. तो ऑल ऑफ द एवव इज करेक्ट, मीन्स की डी इज द राइट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. स्टैंडर्ड इंटरमीडिएट फ्रीक्वेंसी यूज फॉर AM रिसीवर, AM मीन्स एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेटेड रिसीवर इज 455 मेगाहर्ट्ज, 455 किलोहर्ट्ज, 455 हर्ट्ज एंड नन ऑफ द एवर. तो राइट आंसर इज 455 किलोहर्ट्ज, मीन्स की बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक दैट यूजेज द मिनिमम चैनल बैंडविड्थ एंड द ट्रांसमिटेड पावर इज FM, DSBSC, VSB, SSBSC. तो इन दिस केस FM फ्रीक्वेंसी मॉड्यूलेशन, अगर वाइड बैंड होगा तो बहुत सारी साइड बैंड्स होती हैं तो इसकी बैंडविड्थ इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. DSBSC इज द डबल साइड बैंड सप्रेस कैरियर, आपको सारे फुल फॉर्म्स भी आने चाहिए. DSB इज द डबल साइड बैंड सप्रेस कैरियर, इट इंक्लूड्स टू साइड बैंड्स और कैरियर को क्या करते हैं, सप्रेस कर देते हैं. VSB इज द वेस्टिजियल साइड बैंड इन विच वन साइड बैंड इज कम्प्लीटली अवेलेबल एंड द वेस्टिजियल पार्ट मीन्स कि थोड़ा सा पार्ट अवेलेबल होता है अदर साइड बैंड का. बट इन केस ऑफ SSB इज द सिंगल साइड बैंड बिकॉज इट इंक्लूड ओनली सिंगल साइड बैंड. तो अगर सिर्फ और सिर्फ वन साइड बैंड होगी, आइदर वो अपर होगी और लोअर होगी, तो ऑब्वियस है इसकी बैंडविड्थ क्या होगी, रिड्यूस होगी. बैंडविड्थ रिड्यूस होगी और इसका पावर भी कम होगा. तो डी इज द राइट ऑप्शन. द फंक्शन ऑफ मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग इज टू रिड्यूस द बैंडविड्थ ऑफ द सिग्नल टू बी ट्रांसमिटेड टू कंबाइन मल्टीपल डेटा स्ट्रीम्स ओवर अ सिंगल डेटा चैनल टू अलाउ मल्टीपल डेटा स्ट्रीम ओवर मल्टीपल चैनल्स इन अ प्रिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर्मेट टू मैच द फ्रीक्वेंसीज ऑफ द सिग्नल एट द ट्रांसमीटर एज वेल एज द रिसीवर. तो मल्टीप्लेक्सर का मीन्स क्या होता है, इन विच बहुत सारे सिग्नल्स एक साथ आते हैं और ट्रांसमिट होते हैं थ्रू वन चैनल. मीन्स की पैरेलल इन टू सीरियल आउट भी कह सकते हो, मल्टीपल इनपुट टू सिंगल आउटपुट भी आप कह सकते हो. मीन्स की मल्टीप्लेक्सर इज यूज टू कंबाइन द मल्टीपल डेटा स्ट्रीम्स ओवर अ सिंगल डेटा चैनल. तो बी इज द राइट ऑप्शन. For low level modulation, amplifier used is class A, class C, class A and C and none of the above. So for this question, answer is class A amplifier. Now, a question aapka ye bhi ho sakta hai ki what is the low level modulation. So low level modulation means ki before amplification agar modulation hota hai to that is called low level modulation. After amplification agar modulation hota hai to that is called high level modulation. Now, function of RF means ki radio frequency mixer is addition of two signals, multiplication of two signals, rejection of noise and none of the above. So, mixer ka means hai ye signal ko mix karta hai, but don't take on the addition of two signals. It is a multiplication of two signal, means ki B is the right option for this. Now, next question, if a receiver has poor capacity of blocking urgent channel interference, then the receiver has poor selectivity, poor signal to noise ratio, poor sensitivity and none of the above. Basically, iska means kya hua? Ki uski poor capacity hai to blocking. Blocking ka means hai ki wo jo hamara wanted signal hai, uske nearby signal ko block nahi kar pa raha hai. Means ki agar blocking capacity is poor, means ki iski selectivity is also poor. Means ki option A is correct for this. Now, next question, advantages of using a high frequency carrier wave is signal can be transmitted over a very long distance, dissipates very small powers, antenna height of the transmitter is reduced, all of the above. Basically, ye jo tino diye hain, this is the need of modulation. Need of modulation agar hume karna hai, to we require high frequency carrier wave, means ki all of the above is right for this question. Next question is, pilot carrier is used with DSBSC signal, a small carrier transmitted with modulated signal used for synchronization with local carrier at the receiver, all of the above. So for pilot carrier all is correct, means ki all of the above is correct for this, means ki D is the right option. Now, next question. In automatic gain control of AM receiver, gain of the receiver is adjusted. The gain adjustment depends upon the strength of the received signal and the output provided is a DC voltage. All of the above is correct for automatic gain control, means ki D is the right option for this. Next question, intermediate frequency should be carefully chosen as high IF results in poor selectivity. This is correct. High IF results in problem in tracking of signals. Yes, this is also correct. Image frequency rejection become poor at low IF. Means ki all is correct. Means ki D is the right option for this question. ठीक है? ये separately भी पूछ सकता है one one characteristic का. तो ये आपको पता होना चाहिए कि अगर IF की value ज़्यादा हुई, तो poor selectivity होगी, tracking problems होंगी और क्या हो जाएगा? Become it क्या होगी? Image frequency rejection जो होगी, वो भी poor हो जाएगी. Next question, in terms of signal frequency and intermediate frequency FI, the image frequency is given by, मैं formula लिख देती हूँ, F image is equal to given by FS, means कि signal frequency जो input पर signal आ रहा है, plus 2FI, FI is the intermediate frequency, means कि B is the right option. ठीक, इसका ये formula आपको याद होना चाहिए, because हो सकता है कि आपको signal frequency given हो, FI given हो, और आपसे image frequency पूछ ले, image frequency given हो, FS given हो, आपसे FI पूछ ले, any means कि any two frequency components given हो, और आपसे third one पूछ ले, तो that's why ये formula आपका important है for image frequency. Now next question, a pure sine wave, a digital signal, an analog signal can be a digital or analog, neither digital or nor analog. So sine wave is an analog signal, means ki B is the right option for this. FM broadcast lies in which band, HF, SHF, UHF, VHF? So for this question, right answer is D, means ki VHF. But question aapko ye bhi aa sakta hai, particular band given hai and uski frequency aapko pata karni ho, to main yahan par HF ki bata deti hu. HF ki jo range hoti hai, that is 3 to 30 megahertz. This is for HF, and SHF is the super high frequency range, which is given by 3 to 30 gigahertz, clear? And now UHF is the ultra high frequency, which is given by, this is given by 300 to 3000 megahertz. ठीक है? Now what is VHF? VHF is the very high frequency range, जो HF के just बाद होगी, means कि for VHF range is 30 to 300 megahertz, clear? ठीक है? This is the range जो यहाँ पे आपके bands given है, मैंने उनकी बता दी, ये आपको आनी चाहिए. But for this question कि FM broadcast lies in which band, तो right answer is D. FM आपका कहाँ lie करता है? In VHF. Next question, ramp signal is which type of signal? Energy signal, power signal, both energy and power signal, neither energy or nor power signal. So what is the right option? Right option is D. ठीक, why? तो मैं आपको बता देती हूँ कि what is energy signal? अगर कोई भी signal energy signal है, तो it should be an aperiodic signal. Energy signal क्या होना चाहिए? Aperiodic होना चाहिए. ठीक है, अगर कोई power signal है, that should be periodic signal, clear? ठीक है, while जो ramp signal होता है, इसका amplitude continuously increase होता है and goes to infinite level, hence neither a power signal and nor energy signal, clear है? Energy signal should be aperiodic and power signal क्या होते हैं? Periodic होते हैं और जो हमारा ramp signal है, its amplitude is continuously increase and goes to infinite level, hence neither a power signal nor energy signals. So D is the right option for this question. Now next question, the bandwidth required for baseband signals in telephone is 0.3 to 3.4 kilohertz, 3.5 to 7.7 kilohertz, up to 15 kilohertz or up to 20 kilohertz. तो ये generally 3 kilohertz होती है, means की जो range होगी वो 0.3 to 3.4 kilohertz होगी. Baseband signal means की modulating signal, signal which is not modulated. याद रखना है baseband signal है, this is, ठीक है, baseband signal, not passband signal. Next question, in AM when 100% modulation is achieved, if carrier frequency is equal to signal frequency, frequency exceed, carrier frequency exceeds signal frequency, or carrier amplitude is equal to signal amplitude, or amplitude exceeds to signal amplitude. So first of all, hame pata hona chahiye, what is the formula for modulation index? So modulation index is given by M is equal to EM by EC, ठीक है, where EM is the amplitude of signal and EC is the amplitude of the carrier, ठीक, तो now when this value will be equal to 1, when EM EM is equal to EC, or we can say when carrier amplitude is equal to the signal amplitude, means ki 18 ke liye which option is correct? Option C is correct for this. Question: a 360 watt carrier is simultaneously modulated by two audio waves with modulation percentage of 50 and 60 respectively. The total sideband power radiated will be 180, 110, 60 or 30. Okay. So first of all, this is multi-tone signal. So we have to find modulation index. Modulation index is given by m is equal to under root m1 square plus m2 square. Okay. Means ki for this case, m is equal to kya ho jayega? This is 0.5. 0.5 का स्क्वायर प्लस 0.6 का स्क्वायर, दोनों को सॉल्व करेंगे आप, 0.25 प्लस 0.36, देन इट विल बी इक्वल टू 0.61. ठीक. नाउ अब हमें क्या मिल गया, एम की वैल्यू मिल गई. हमें फाइंड आउट क्या करना है, हमें साइड बैंड पावर फॉर्म फाइंड आउट करनी है. तो जो ये एम की वैल्यू मिल गई, इसको हम यूज करेंगे. नाउ साइड बैंड पावर कैसे गिवन होती है, पी एस बी इज इक्वल टू पी सी m square by 2. ठीक है. Now PC is given, PC की वैल्यू दे रखी है 360, m square क्या हो जाएगा 0.61 by 2. ठीक है. Now इसको आप अगर सॉल्व करोगे तो 180 into 0.61. ठीक है. तो जब हम इसको सॉल्व करेंगे तो we get the answer. Answer क्या हो, after multiplication 180 into 0.61, what we get? We get V09.8, which is approximately equal to 1110. So B is the right option. In AM receiver, the oscillator frequency is always equal to signal frequency, always equal to 455 kilohertz, always higher than the signal frequency, always lower than the signal frequency. So oscillator jo hota hai, that generate high frequency signal, which is carrier signal. So wo kya ho jayega? Answer C is the correct. Theek hai? Means ki always higher than the signal frequency. Next question, the number of spectral component when two sine waves are multiplied are 1, 2, 8, 4. So, right option is 4, means ki D is the correct for this. Now, next question, in a balanced bridge modulator, the carrier frequency should be at least times dash times the highest modulating frequency 1, 2, 3 and N. So, right option is 2. Theek hai? Just double honi chahiye. Clear hai? Approximately at least double honi chahiye. Usse jyada ho sakti hai. Next question, the passband of the tuned circuit of a radio receiver should be 5 kHz, 10 kHz, 20 kHz and 200 kHz. So it should be 10 kHz. Okay, B is the right option. Now, next question, what will be the oscillator frequency for the tuning in 600 kHz on an AM radio with a 455 kilohertz IF. ठीक है, तो हम इसकी frequency क्या होती है, relationship बता देती हूँ पहले तो, कि oscillator frequency, local oscillator frequency FLO is given by FS plus FI. ठीक है, F, this is FS, clear, FS. ठीक है, और FS की value क्या दे रखी है, 600, and FI की value क्या है, 455, तो it will be equal to 1055 kilohertz. तो B is the right answer. तो ये आपको पता होना चाहिए, एक आपको image frequency का formula पता होना चाहिए, एक आपको local oscillator की frequency का formula भी पता होना चाहिए. This is the last question of this video. In super heterodyne receiver, the IF signal is rectified by audio section, IF section, detector and none of these. So right option is C, IF signal is rectified by the detector portion, means ki demodulation jahan hota hai. So C is the right option. I hope you like this video. Still you have any doubt in any question, please write down in comment section. Thank you so much.